My life, reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder in every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceful, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or sincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess, because you do not ask. You ask, but you do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your own passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of the Lord.
in professional sports culture, there is regular discussion about who the GOAT is in a particular sport. The word GOAT being an acronym for the greatest of all time. So asking who the GOAT is essentially asking who is the greatest football player, or basketball player, or hockey player, or baseball player. Right now, Tom Brady is widely recognized as the GOAT in football. Wayne Gretzky had the moniker, the Great One, even while he was still playing hockey, and is considered hockey's GOAT, if you will. Michael Jordan has the same status in basketball, and in the world of boxing, Muhammad Ali was considered the greatest, and his autobiography bore that title. I share this with you, of course, because this is the question that Jesus is seeking to answer for his disciples in the gospel this morning as to who is the greatest among them. The disciples had been arguing about which of them was the greatest. In biblical times, the greatest one was the most powerful, the most influential, the one with the most prestige and status. In today's society, people like Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos might be considered great by some people because of their wealth and power and influence. Jesus turns this understanding of greatness on its head, however, by defining greatness in a radical and completely different way. He tells his disciples that in order to be first, they must become the last of all and the servant of all. In effect, he is suggesting that in order to become powerful and influential, you must become powerless. You must empty yourself and seek to serve the needs of everyone else except yourself. Jesus uses a child as an example of what he is trying to teach them. Because, of course, in ancient times, children were considered nobodies. They were powerless. They had no influence. They had no voice. They had zero status or prestige. In a word, they were the last of all, according to society's standards. But Jesus is communicating to his disciples that if you welcome this person who the world considers to be insignificant, this child, you are welcoming me, and not only me, but God, the one who sent me. All of this comes, of course, after Jesus had once again told his disciples that he would be handed over to men and be killed, and would rise 3 days later. And the disciples' response to this, they start an argument about who among them is the greatest. In other words, they completely missed the boat. They didn't have a clue about what Jesus was communicating to them. The men who would hand Jesus over, however, Judas, the chief instruments in the larger divine plan for the salvation of the world. God hands over his Son. The Son, Jesus, willingly hands himself over out of obedience to the Father and out of love for us. Jesus is not a victim. Jesus is the master of his fate when he pours himself and his life out on the cross in his greatest act of service and humility. In effect, Jesus is teaching his disciples that the greatest power, the most effective influence, is the power to deprioritize the self and serve the needs of others. This is what God is demonstrating in the life and death and resurrection of his Son. In the Hebrew scriptures, in the Old Testament, it is said, "Cursed is anyone who is hanged on a tree," meaning anyone who dies on the wood of the cross makes themselves the lowest of the low. This is precisely what Jesus did. He takes upon himself, he becomes the target of all of the violence and evil of the world. By dying his death on the cross, Jesus serves all humanity by taking all of humanity's evil upon himself. This is the model or the paradigm that God is providing for us. It is the way of selfless service and self-sacrificial love. Who is the greatest? It is the one who follows the example of God himself in the person of his Son, Jesus Christ. The one who becomes the last of all and the servant of all humanity. The one who takes upon himself all the evil in the world in order to liberate humanity for the greatest freedom, the freedom to love and serve others. your kingdom, the last become first, the gentle are strong, and the lowly are exalted. Give us wisdom from above, that we may find in your servant Jesus the pattern of true discipleship and the grace to persevere in following him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let him during the preparation of gifts on the 680 final law, number 680.
Amen.
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the Explore the Bible's invitation to find our stability, security, and rest in God, starting this coming Wednesday at 9:45 a.m. in Father Dorgan Hall at St. Mary's. Please see the bulletin for details. Next weekend is St. Vincent de Paul's annual Bundle Sunday. Please bring your no longer needed clothing, linens, and shoes to Father Morgan Hall at St. Mary's before all masses to donate. And finally,